The demo that I'm going to tee up for us in the next couple minutes here is this introducing a concept of being able to apply in-band network telemetry to existing protocols. TCP is one of the most common protocols that runs a large part of almost all applications out there. And so what we've done here is being able to apply INT onto TCP. And so what we're going to do is we're going to apply end-to-end network telemetry all the way through the end application and be able to instrument and see what is the latency. Most applications are very latency-centric, and so as you add more performance or more a higher workload onto your network starts to slow down. And the beauty about TCP is it's already an existing protocol. You don't have to change any of your existing infrastructure. You can make this ride on all of the existing pieces of your network that you have. And then it's very easy to adapt. And what you're going to do, what we're going to show you here, is that we're going to estimate what's happening in the network, and we're going to apply a new congestion control technique that's actually going to be able to unleash additional performance for you in your applications. And so the benefits clearly for all of our enterprise users is the increased ROI, one hardware that adapts with what's going on in the network, and it reduces latency and network downtime. So how does TCP-INT work? It's basically embedded into the TCP headers. The TCP header has the ability to have option or extend option headers and be able to do that. And what we're going to be doing is it's very lightweight. What it does is a packet goes through a network. You're adding the ability to look at queue depth or latency and estimate congestion that you're seeing in the network. And so as the packet traverses through all these different nodes in the network, it's going to collect up all the data, the what's happening to it as it goes through each node, and then going to be able to collect that up. And so we're doing this on a storage workload with NVMe over TCP, one of the more newer protocols that is out there in terms of storage applications. So you're seeing we're keeping up with the pace of change in what people need today. So I'm going to tee up a little video here, and I'll walk you through what's going on. It's going to, you know, keep it a little bit fast pace in terms of what we're seeing. And so our vision here is to be able to apply this to every single network workload. We're applying this here to networking workload. And so I wanted you to see how TCP-INT not only gives you the ability to instrument an existing workload, but also allows you to unleash additional performance. So let's start off here and get the video started. So what we're going to see here is how TCP-INT can be used to measure and identify the problems in a network. And so in our storage benchmark performance tests, we've observed that as the number of initiators increase, latency observed in the by the application increases and going from there. So what does TCP-INT do? It reports the telemetry information from the network and collects it and analyzes it in real time by Deep Insight, which is our AI power software. So first off, what does it do? It measures the throughput as experienced by the host network, TCP stack. It exactly quantifies the occupancy of the queues and the switches. It sees the latency contributed by the switches as a measure of the total application latency. And then when congestion occurs, it shows how the sender reacts. So now as we increase the number of initiators sending traffic, we can clearly identify the points of congestion, as you can see here in the network. The first thing we observe is that throughput drops. We also observe that an increase in the queue occupancy of the last hop switch. That's where the congestion is. Next, we see additional latency being introduced in the network because of the congestion events. And lastly, we see how the sender TCP reacts to the congestion event by manipulating its congestion window size. So now that we've identified the cause of the congestion, let's pivot to how do we resolve this issue. First, you get all the benefits of it. So existing algorithms like data center TCP use ECN to estimate the degree of congestion. It needs many ACK packets, each delivering one or zero information, and it's slow and imprecise. So slow detection leads to more packet drops, which affects your SLAs and consequently your revenue. So TCP-INT is able to react to the congestion immediately in the TCP option header, and we now have the exact queue depth of the most congested switch and the total accumulated fabric latency. This gives us the agility to make a timely reaction with fewer ACK packets, faster time to detect issues, and efficiently use the resources available, delivering better services. So let's switch gears and move to a larger cluster. and scaled distribution environment with a mixture of latency-sensitive RPC clients and bulk senders coming across or accessing a common server. So this typical scenario often results in congestion at the last hop switch, so slightly different what we saw. Each of these switches and hosts are enabled with TCP-INT, and the host sends the telemetry data back to Intel Deep Insight. So this allows us to quickly detect and visualize the impact of congestion and latency on the application. So slightly different demo topology that we have in the second case. And so first, we're going to go back and visualize with Deep Insight how the network is performing and reacting with regular ECN-based traffic and with the existing congestion control algorithms, such as data center TCP. And what we see is a high occupancy alluding to congestion in the network. Now, with the same topology, same application, the same set of bulk senders, we switch to a congestion control algorithm using TCP-INT together with ECN. And you can observe that there's an immediate reduction of up to 40% in the queue occupancy of the congested switch. This is due to the sender's ability to immediately reconfigure its transmission rate. On our test beds and topology with TCP-INT, we were actually able to reduce the packet drops on a network and achieve a lower end-to-end tail latency. This meant that the application saw an even higher throughput of up to 2.5 times more RPC transactions per connection. That means 2.5 more users with the exact same hardware that you had ultimately. And we've been able to show that rich telemetry data is not only useful to be able to help you diagnose what the problem is and be able to see what's going on, but also be able to use the existing piece of hardware and existing network resources and capacity, and finally be able to improve the overall performance of the network in our applications. So, very quick demo. I know it was rapidly going on, available for those of you that you wanted to be able to see this. And this is all powered through the programmability of the network switches, as well as the network endpoints that we had there. So whether it's the NICs, the software that's running on it, or the storage appliances that you had, and this is an application that is now being deployed pretty much in all new enterprises that are out there. And so what you see here is the benefits of that telemetry powered by programmability and that P4, being able to reduce packet drops, lower the overall latency, get you more value for your money at the end of the day, and so you save on your infrastructure costs by adapting not only to NVMe over TCP, keeping your uptime up, but then ultimately going to what you're trying to do is provide more performance to your customers.